So a lot of people have asked me over the years, what about national defense? Because every country needs to preserve its sovereignty, needs to have the means to preserve its sovereignty. And the answer really is not that complicated. The territory of Western Canada would have to be defended by Western Canadians, and the sovereignty of Western Canada would have to be defended. The exact territorial dimensions of Western Canada haven't been determined, but they could be determined by each province in a referendum. And it could also be that each of the northern territories could determine their destiny by a referendum as well. They might want to be part of Western Canada, they might not. That's for those people to decide. But on the basis of the assumption that they decided in favor of Western Canada, that creates a large area in which defense is necessary and to maintain the territorial integrity. What are we doing now in that regard? Well, we have a large military force in Afghanistan today. We're not going to bring peace to Afghanistan, and we are eventually going to have to withdraw with very little long-term benefits to the Afghan people. That's an unfortunate strategic error. It's an error of government, an error of politics, but that's only mentioned in this context to demonstrate how much better we could do for ourselves. If we were to determine foreign policy on the basis of a rational discussion, we wouldn't even be in Afghanistan. There's no strategic reason for being there. But what we have in Western Canada that would do better is a concept of Western Canadian identity and nationalism. We have the resources in Western Canada to produce a debt-free country, which simply means that we would have the money to buy all the latest and any necessary military equipment for defense. There are many options in how we could defend ourselves. We could have a regular armed forces, three services as there is. We could vary that so that we could have well-trained militia units locally established in each territory with a sort of territorial integrity, subdividing the responsibility of defense into local jurisdiction. And this might actually be the best way to maintain the defense of Western Canada, because people tend to love their immediate territory best, and they might also be most familiar with the local landmarks, the local territorial strategic areas, and they might in fact be entrusted with a certain amount of a budget to develop a local defense plan, which could equally be compatible with a search and rescue or emergency response plan in the local area, so that you have delegated all those functions to the local community. Therefore, if the command and control structure was damaged, or if there was a major crisis that took out the national command and control structure, the local unit could still function autonomously within its jurisdiction for the benefit of its local inhabitants. And you know and I know that in a society that could break down in an emergency, this local autonomy is essential for the preservation of law and order and civil security. This, therefore, is one of the options. It's only one of the options, but it's one of the options that Western Canada could develop for itself. It would develop also a local sense of community, because your military command structure at the local level would be local people. And there is, of course, the inclination of local people to be well familiar with each other. It develops a sense of community. Local training for young men and women in the defense of the local area, or handling of local emergencies, or a search and rescue capability locally. Well, why is it better for the people who live there? Because they know the territory. These are options that we could have. Canada as a whole has no military preparedness capable of dealing with national emergencies, search and rescue, or national defense. And this vacuum of leadership is the result of the fact that the military has been a political football, a patronage game within Canada. You can't talk about the military of Western Canada without talking about the problems that exist in the Canadian military today. The reason why we could do better is because they're doing so poorly. We could do so much better because we'd start to think about it for ourselves with the huge resources of Western Canada. There'd be no debt that would burden us when Western Canadian uranium and potash and oil and natural gas and fresh water and all the minerals of Western Canada are available to develop our own military manufacturing capability, which we'll never have when all the contracts are given to Ontario and Quebec. So not only could we develop secondary industry for the manufacturing of defense equipment, we could in fact develop a local, autonomous military structure that would build a sense of community and national pride and local pride, so that a local military unit would be identified by its own symbols, its own uniform designations, and its own command structure. Can you imagine how enormously binding that would be on a local community to have the continuity of its own little military cemetery where those who served throughout the years were buried, and its own military central training position, so that over the years a father, a son, a grandfather, and all the descendants of that group could train in the same facility? No. That's what I'd like to see for Western Canada. But in Canada, it will never be. When my father went off to war in 1941, he signed up in 1940, he went to the Central Training Depot in Toronto, and there was a question about who's from the West, and somebody shouted out, F the West, because everyone had to come from the West to be trained. And everyone knew, as they do now, that anybody in control is going to be Central Canadian. The muscle and the courage and the dedication comes from the local farm boy from Western Canada. But the command and control, we all know where that is. That's in Ottawa, owned and operated by Ontario and Quebec. The contracts are let to Ontario and Quebec. The money is spent in Ontario and Quebec. And time after time, those who are left to bleed and die are from Western Canada. That's not good enough. It wasn't good enough in the two wars, and it's not good enough now.